So one of the most basic functions of using a mail app like Mac Mail is to use email signatures. These are little things that appear at the bottom of all the email that you send. It's really simple to set up email signatures in Mail. All you need to do is go to Mail Preferences and then from there click on Signatures. And then you'll get this list here, three columns. And this is where it gets a little bit confusing, because if you have multiple accounts, like I have an iCloud account and a Google account, both are email accounts that I use to send and receive email. And I've got them listed here, and I also have something called All Signatures. So creating a single signature to use everywhere is pretty easy. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the plus button, and it's going to give it a name, like signature number one. I could change that to whatever I want. So I can call it, say, main sig. And then it's going to fill it in with my name and email address. Now, this is a text area, and I could change this to whatever I want. So for instance, I might think it's probably unnecessary to have my email address there. They're getting email from me. They can reply to me. So maybe just have my name. Or maybe put my company name there. Or even a URL that they can click on. I like to keep things simple though, so I usually just name and a company name or something like that. Maybe this might be good. Now that I've got that, notice on the left here it says all signatures, one signature. For iCloud it says there's zero, and for Google there's zero. You can have multiple signatures and you can assign them to each account. So in order to use a signature, now I need to assign it to one of these accounts. Let's say I want to assign it to both. I'm going to use it for both. So I'm going to drag and drop there and drag and drop again. Now you can see I've got one under all signatures and one under iCloud, one under Google. If I select Google, you could see it shows me the same thing for all of these. Now I'm not done yet, because what I want to do is I want to choose a signature I'm going to use for each one of these. So I'm going to select iCloud first, and at the bottom here it says choose signature, and I can choose which one I want. I can choose main sig there. I'm going to do the same thing for Google. Now that I've got that set up, I can use this. So I can do new message, and my signature is going to be put there automatically, and I can start typing above it and it's added. Now you can get a lot more complex. You can add other signatures. So for instance, I could create one called biz signature, and you know, this is for business email. I can create one called, you know, personal sig here, and maybe this is just going to be my name. And I can add these to what I want. So maybe I want both of these to be under iCloud, but for Google I don't use my business signature there, so I'm just going to personal sig. Now I can look, iCloud's got all three, Google's got all two, adjust those two, and I could change what I want to use. So maybe here I want to make the default my personal signature, and under iCloud I want to make the default my business signature. So what does this do? I've got three under iCloud, two under Google. So now when I compose a new message, notice that in addition to the signature, the default one being placed there, I can change it. So I can change it here. I have all three available because I'm sending from that iCloud account. So I can change to personal, I can change to main, whatever I want. If I was going from my Gmail account, then I would only have personal and main, so only those two that are there. Notice also this gives me the ability to jump right into editing signatures again. And also you have some really cool options, like I could say for choosing a signature, instead of choosing one of these as the default, choose one at random or go through sequential order. So go the first one and the next email I send is the second one, next one's the third one. Why these? Well, a lot of times people like to put, say, inspirational quotes or something like that in their email. So this way it kind of varies. You can have 20 different signatures of neat quotes and then say just choose one at random and stick it there. That's why people use those. So this is how you do it. If you ever want to edit this, I mean, you could go in and say, okay, under Google I don't want to use my main signature there ever. I just want a personal signature. Under iCloud I never want to use personal signature. You do the minus button there. You can see only those two are available. You can have extra signatures under all signatures that aren't even here and swap them in and out whenever you want. You also you know, can use the default message font or uncheck that. You can actually copy and paste styled text from text edit or pages into here to use bold and colors and things like that. You can also choose to place a signature above any quoted text in reply. So you have that option as well. So I hope this gets you started with using email signatures. At the very least, just create one, add it to all of your accounts, and then use that as your main and only signature. That's pretty much what I do. But if you have the need, you have all these other options to create all sorts of interesting signatures and use them in all sorts of ways.